Some say fuses come in too many different sizes, and after some research, I'm inclined to believe them. However, fuse technology has been advancing to keep up with car design trends, as well as generally maintaining ease of use while reducing costs for the vehicle owner and manufacturer. In fact, this relatively new and weird Micro3 fuse is my new favorite. Now, if you don't agree with me or simply have no idea what you're looking at right now, let's first take a journey through the history of automotive fuses to see how we got to this thing. At first glance, automotive fuses play a deceptively simple-looking role, preventing current from getting too high and damaging expensive parts. Before we discuss what more there is, let's take a look at some of the earliest fuse types found in vehicles. Early automotive fuses were typically long, round components with a precisely sized strip of metal. That strip was designed to melt apart so it would cut off the circuit if amperage got too high. Not only that, but the metal strip needed to be visible, so if an electrical issue did happen, the owner or mechanic could check the fuse box and find the fuse. This provided the benefit of not only making the fuse in need of replacement easy to find, but the circuit in need of inspection easy to find too. While glass tube fuses are a readily available example of the type of fuse from the era, Bosch type and Lucas type fuses were also found on older vehicles for a while. For high amperage circuits, bolt down fuses were used. Those basic fuse types handled circuit protection for a long time, but as engine bays became more and more packed with additional electronic components, the amount of fuses needed increased, while the space available to them decreased. In the 1970s, bladed fuses started appearing in vehicle fuse boxes. This new design still protected circuits with the same strip of metal design, but allowed many more fuses to fit in the fuse box. Since their shell was made out of plastic, they could be color-coded for quick identification based on amperage. For example, most 10-amp blade fuses are red, and most 15-amp blade fuses are blue. Regular blade fuses will typically be found in a range from 1 amp to 40 amps, while the larger Maxi fuse variety typically ranges from 15 amps all the way up to 120 amps. Technology improvements keep happening, so fuses continue to shrink down to fit smaller engine bays. In the 1990s, mini-bladed fuses began appearing, as well as the low-profile mini. The low-profile mini had the same distance between the blades as the mini, but placed the fuse between the contact points instead of above them. Fuses that needed to deal with higher amperage and temperatures would switch from bolt-down bars to cartridge designs. The early 2000s had quite a variety of fuse options available, but not to worry, design changes didn't stop there. Our most recent bladed fuses are the Micro 2 and Micro 3 designs. The 2 starts with the design of the Mini and takes the next logical step for technology and goes even smaller. However, the Micro 3 takes compact design a step further. Someone realized that so many fuses in the fuse box share common circuitry, so circuitry splits could occur at the fuse itself. The center contact point of a Micro 3 fuse is the common point, and the split occurs in the fuse element itself, so the left leg and right leg go to two different components. Some design consideration has to be made to pair circuits together that need the same amperage rating of protection, but the result is a lot of saved space and a lower piece count in the fuse box. Upon seeing these fuses for the first time, my initial reaction was, isn't it wasteful to have to throw out a fuse that's still half good? But then I realized that these fuses are smaller than the original bladed fuse size, so from a material waste perspective, it's still an improvement. Down the road, if these start getting popular enough to be the standard, I can see manufacturers popping these into fuse boxes that sometimes just use two of the three contacts on models missing extra features, which may mean if one of these blows out and there isn't a contact on the other side, you could actually turn the fuse around and use the other side. There's another interesting bit of fuse information that I haven't seen anyone talking about, and that is fuse service quality. Here I have four examples of a typical bladed fuse, and while they all have different amperage ratings, they are all the same case design. However, each of these will probably get a different reaction out of you if you encounter them. This one right here is the typical one I encounter. These two are interesting, and I rarely encounter them, but they actually let you see the fuse element without having to pull the fuse out. With these two, you have to pull them out to look at them. In addition, one of these is covered, which probably means that it won't have to deal with corrosion, but this one that isn't sealed can be tested with a multimeter. That's where we get into my least favorite of these four. This one is super annoying. Low quality in every way, and even worse, they are becoming more common. These have just enough metal to get to the fuse element and nothing more. Alternatively, you can see on the top of this one that the legs go all the way up and that they make it to the top so you can test them with a multimeter. This one is made out of cloudy plastic, probably because it's cheap to begin with, but also because you're less likely to notice the other things they have cheaped out on. Now, these still have holes in them, so technically with the right adapting probes, you can still stick a multimeter on this, but from a DIY perspective, that's an annoying purchase to have to make, and from a technician's perspective, it's time used up switching out probes. You know it's not going to be just one design or another in an older car, it's going to be a mix. So, when you're buying fuses, if you have options, pay a little more for the ones that aren't junk. Check out our videos on fuse boxes and multimeters on the screen now, and thanks for watching Car Simplified.